According to a new report, the 2+ years of student loan freezes in this country, where you didn't have to make any student loan payments, actually raised the credit scores of 79% of student loan borrowers. Now, the biggest increase in the credit reports for those who still owed student loans were, of course, the people whose student loans were delinquent. They were behind on payments, they were having trouble, so that was hurting their credit. But now, because of this freeze, that is about to expire, by the way, those people's credit scores went up, along with, again, 79% of everyone who is holding student loan debt today. Why is that so significant? And I know our overseas audience may be a little confused at this concept of credit scores, because they don't have to deal with crap like that. That's an American thing we have here. But let me put it this way. If you have a bad credit score, you cannot buy a car. You cannot buy a house. You can't get a loan really of any kind. And if you do get a loan, you're going to pay an interest rate that's absolutely through the roof. Sometimes a bad credit score can even prevent you from getting certain jobs here in the United States. It hinders your ability to move upward in this country. Those credit scores, those numbers that we are identified by the big banks, determine our future. And that's why it's so important that almost 80% of student loan borrowers saw their credit scores increase. Suddenly we had people that were able to pay off other debts that they had because they weren't hyper-focused on their student loans. They were able to get right financially. They were able to pay down other debts, of course, which is what raised their credit score. Their debt-to-income ratio evened out a little bit better. Debt level went down to make those ratios a little bit better to, again, increase the credit scores. And here we are. In August of 2022, student loan debt payments about to restart. Everybody's sitting on pins and needles. Oh, is Biden going to forgive it? Is he going to forgive $10,000? Is it going to be $50,000? Is it only going to be for people making under $70,000 a year? Is he going to means test it? Is he not? Who's going to get it? How do we get it? This is ridiculous. We have seen report after report, study after study, poll after poll, showing us how great it has been for these people not having to make these payments. And these federal student loans, which is what a majority of the student loan debt is from the federal government, can all be forgiven with the stroke of a pen from President Biden. He doesn't have to means test any of it, which I think honestly is absolutely ridiculous, because means testing is a one size fits all, you make this, you don't get it type scenario where, okay, if you're making $100,000, you don't qualify for it. Well, $100,000 in a state like Alabama that is, you know, as the UN describes, suffering from third world levels of poverty, $100,000 there is a hell of a lot of money. $100,000 in New York City is not. But we put that one size fits all label on them, so you could have somebody living a high life in Alabama that still gets their student loans paid off, somebody who can't even afford rent in New York City that suddenly doesn't qualify. Forgive all of it. All of it, every bit of it. I don't care if you've got people with $20 million in the bank and $10,000 in student loans. Forgive it. A blanket, one size fits all. If you have it, it's gone. That's what should happen. There are not downsides to this. And if there are, there's far more good things that happen. People's lives have been made better. Their chance for upward mobility in this country has increased, because they're not having to make these payments. Let's help these people. Biden can do it. And nobody can tell him no. That's the worst part of this story. He can do it, but he hasn't. It's time to put the pressure on. Maybe we need John Stewart, right, to go out there and start advocating for full student loan forgiveness the way he did for that veterans' healthcare bill. Maybe then something would happen. Because every report that's come out has shown how this has made people's lives so much better, and Biden could deliver them permanent relief like that.
This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.